Cranial nerve 7 is your facial nerve. It is a mixed motor, it's a mixed cranial nerve. It has a motor component, which is further subdivided into somatic or axons that innervate skeletal muscle, and a visceral component, axons that innervate smooth muscle or glands. And in this case, it's a parasympathetic component that's going to innervate some salivary glands. There's a sensory component to the facial nerve, and that is the special sense of taste coming from the anterior two-thirds of the tongue. We can see on our model here that the seventh cranial nerve is right here, kind of next to the vestibulocochlear nerve. And here is the seventh cranial nerve, and again, it's right next to our vestibulocochlear. What I failed to mention when I was talking about the vestibulocochlear and our special senses lecture is that both of these nerves are coming through the skull at a place called the internal auditory meatus. So internal auditory meatus. And meatus is just another word for hole. We have foramen, we have all kinds of different, foramens mostly, and meatuses, they're all different words for holes, because you have a lot of holes in your skull. So next, this is an image to show you the distribution of cranial nerve 7 in the face. So cranial nerve 7 is motor to the muscles of facial expression. And we can only see a few of those. I have another image of this later in the lecture to show more of the muscles of facial expression. But we can see some of them here. Here's one, your orbicularis oculi. There's the orbicularis oris, and there's some your zygomaticus major here. These are muscles that Dr. Alsop probably talked a great deal more about in the musculoskeletal MOOC. There's also, though, these nerve branches of 7 can be seen here. This part of the nerve exits through the stylomastoid foramen, which is right behind your ear, right between the mastoid bone and the styloid process. We have branches. We have a temporal branch, a zygomatic branch, a buccal branch, because it goes over the buccinator muscle, a marginal mandibular branch, and a cervical branch, which kind of comes down here and innervates your platysma. So we have T, Z, B, M, and C. There's all kinds of mnemonics to help you remember these branches. The one that I learned when I was a graduate student was, two zebras bit my cupcake. I didn't even know zebras like cupcakes, but that is the mnemonic I learned, and it helps me remember these branches. The parasympathetic component of the seventh cranial nerve innervates a couple of glands. One of them, let me erase and then redraw, is the submandibular gland. Submandibular, right underneath the mandible. And this is one of your salivary glands. It also innervates the sublingual gland, which is inside the oral cavity, just under the tongue. And so this image is to show you some of the muscles of facial expression in a little bit more detail. So there's our beautiful orbicularis oculi. Here's our zygomaticus major and minor, orbicularis oris. There's another, there's all kinds of, there's a depressor labii. And so these are the muscles that are the targets of the cranial nerve 7, the motor component. So cranial nerve 7 mixed. Muscles of facial expression, which are pictured here, and the sublingual and submandibular glands. And the sensory aspect of the facial nerve is the special sense of taste for the anterior or presulcal part of the tongue. And that's, again, a reminder for that is in the next slide. And here, again, here's the sulcus, and then here's the part that's innervated by cranial nerve 7. Cranial nerve 9 innervates this part of the tongue, the glossopharyngeal, and way back in the larynx and pharynx, where you have a few sensory fibers, those are going to be innervated by cranial nerve 10. So what do I want you to know about cranial nerve 5 and 7? I want you to remember that they're both mixed. I want you to think about which cranial nerve innervates the muscles of mastication, which cranial nerve innervates the muscles of facial expression, which cranial nerve innervates the submandibular and sublingual glands. What are the name branches of the trigeminal nerve, and what general regions do they innervate? What type of sensation is related by the trigeminal nerve, and from what general regions? And then which branches of the trigeminal are sensory only, and which ones are mixed? If you have a grasp of all of these concepts, then you'll be ready for the assessment.